The affirmative continue to defend the fact that the minimum wage is not enough to survive on. And I would like to readdress the idea that it's not meant to make a living off of. It's meant for people to either transition from one job to the other, or just to kind of get a start, or even get experience, as many employers ask for experience when applying for the jobs. But in fact, the majority of the people working at minimum wage are people under 25. In an article by Drew D. Silver of September 2014, he states that people at or below the federal minimum wage are under 25. 50% of them are between the ages of 16 and 24, and 24% of them are teenagers between 16 and 19. That means that 74% of the people working at minimum wage are teens, or that don't live on their own and don't really have things that they need to be paying for. So they shouldn't need to be making more than what is the minimum wage now. In addition, the Heritage Foundation, in one of their articles, states that 3/4 of older workers earning minimum wage live above the poverty line. They have an average family income of $42,000. That's almost double of what the poverty line states, says that the income is for families in poverty. In addition, there's a misunderstanding of who would be affected by this. Because it's so many people are teenagers or below 25, the people who are targeted wouldn't actually see an effect. According to the Census Bureau, roughly 60% of the people living in poverty don't currently work, so raising the minimum wage wouldn't help the economy or the people to get out of poverty, because the majority of them don't benefit from the raise. The affirmatives also continue to debate that raising the minimum wage would stimulate the economy. But in an article written by John Whitney, he states that the minimum wage has been risen from 25 cents to $7.25 since it was instituted in 1938. And despite such an increase, inflation has eroded its value. That means every time that the minimum wage is raised, inflation goes up and it kind of takes away the point of raising it. It'll also cause job losses. Douglas Holt states that while many minimum wage advocates hope that employers pay for the additional cost with their own profits, evidence suggests that the vast majority of low wage workers are in the industries that have razor thin profits. Raising the minimum wage would basically force them to cut jobs because they cannot afford to lose any more of their profit in order to make up for this additional money being spent on labor. Thank you.